Mandukya Upanishad, Part 1. It is not exactly known how this Upanishad got its name. There are several possibilities given. One possibility is that this Upanishad is associated with a rishi named Manduka, and hence the name Mandukya Upanishad. Another reason is that the word Manduka in Sanskrit means a frog. Some people suggest that since in Mandukya Upanishad the teaching is given in stages, the Upanishad leaps from one stage to another, just like a frog leaps from one place to another. Mandukya Upanishad is one of the shortest Upanishads. It has only 12 mantras. Mandukya Upanishad presents the Vedantic knowledge in capsule form, which is extremely hard to understand. However, sage Gaudapada, who was Shankaracharya's guru's guru, has provided extensive commentary on this Upanishad. This commentary is called Gaudapada Karika, consisting of 215 mantras, and both the Upanishad and the Karikas are always studied together. Mandukya Upanishad is glorified by another Upanishad called Muktikopanishad, which contains a list of 108 Upanishads. Muktikopanishad says that if you can only study one Upanishad, Mandukya is sufficient. The Upanishad consists of four chapters. The first chapter contains the Upanishad and some of the Karikas. The other three chapters, consisting of the remaining Karikas, are titled Vaitatya Prakaranam, Advaita Prakaranam, and Alada Shanti Prakaranam. If you recall the teachings of the previous Upanishads, Atma or Brahman is pure consciousness. Consciousness is not a part, product, or property of the body. It is an independent entity that pervades and enlivens the body. Consciousness is not limited by the boundaries of the body. Consciousness survives the death of the body. And I myself, the witness principle, is this Atma or Brahman. Mandukya assumes that the student is familiar with this teaching and proceeds to the next level. The existence of any object is proved only when it is knowable and becomes known at some point of time. Let us say there is an object that can never be known at any time. No one would acknowledge that object as valid. Next, for that object to be known, there needs to be a knower, and there must be a consciousness to know this object. So any object is dependent on consciousness to be validated. Whereas consciousness is itself proof of its existence. Even if I am suspended in deep space with nothing around me, I know I am, and therefore I myself am proof of my existence. Therefore, Vedanta says consciousness has independent existence and any object or matter has dependent existence. This independent existence is technically called Satyam, and dependent existence is called Mithya. This is a very crucial and important definition. Now, what about the knower? A knower comes into existence only when consciousness decides to become a knower by operating a sense organ. For example, I need to open my eyes and choose to look to know colors and shapes. During deep sleep, I don't operate my sense organs or intellect, so I am not a knower. So the knower depends on consciousness, and therefore the knower is also mithya. The known object and the knower are both mithya, since they are both dependent on consciousness. Now, Mandukya says, I, the consciousness, am functioning as both knower and the known. How is this possible? How does gold appear as bangle and chain? Through different names and forms. Similarly, Mandukya says that I appear as both knower and known through different names and forms. Not only that, Mandukya says, I, the consciousness, appear as the entire world with different names and forms. Mandukya then classifies the entire material universe into three aspects: the gross universe, stula prapanja, experienced in waking state; the subtle universe, sukshma prapanja, experienced in dream state; and the causal universe, karana prapanja, experienced in deep sleep state. In the first aspect, pratama pada of waking state, I function as the knower, Vishwa, and the known world, Virat. In the second aspect, dvitiya pada of dream state, I function as the knower, Taijasa, and the known world, Hiranyagarbha. In the third aspect, tritiya pada of deep sleep state, I function as the knower, Prajna, and the known world, Ishvara. In all these three aspects, I have name and form. If I look at myself without any name and form, then I am Turiya or Chaturtham, meaning fourth, which is pure consciousness as it is. Turiya is the screen on which the states of existence are projected. The screen is intimately associated with the movie, but is not tainted by it. Similarly, Turiya is the substratum of all three states of existence. This is analogous to bangle, chain, ring, and as fourth, pure gold, without name and form. Due to these three aspects and the all-pervading Turiya, I am called Chatushpad Brahman, the four-faceted consciousness. Next, we wonder about the nature of these names and forms. Are they an independent substance or are they a property of Atma? The Upanishad says that these are neither substance nor property, but mithya or adhyasa. They are experienced, but they have dependent existence, so they are mithya. I alone am satyam. The world is mithya. The Upanishad gives us a detailed description of this Chatushpad Brahman in the famous 7th mantra. Nanta prajnam, not the inward-turned consciousness, dream state. Na bahish prajnam, not the outward-turned consciousness, waking state. Nobayata prajnam, nor in between. Na prajnanaganam, nor a mass of consciousness. Na prajnam, not knowing. The self becomes a knower only by choice. Na prajnam, not unknowing. Adrishtam, invisible. Avyavaharyam, without transactions. Agrahyam, intangible, ungraspable. Alakshanam, without any properties. Achintyam, inconceivable, unthinkable. Avyabhadesyam, indescribable, unteachable, indefinable. Ekatma pratyayasaram, the sole essence of being. Prapanchopasamam, transcendent beyond the universe. Shantam, peaceful. Shivam, blissful, infinite. Advaitam, without a second. Chaturtam manyante sa atma sa vijnayaha, that which is known as the fourth, that is the Atman to be realized. Turiya also means fourth. In the last five mantras, the Upanishad provides us a tool for meditating upon this Chatushpad Brahman, Omkara. Om is made up of three letters, A, Akara, U, Ukara, M, Makara. Akara is equated to Vishwa Virat of the waking state. Ukara is equated to Taijasa Hiranyagarbha of the dream state. Makara is equated to Prajna Ishvara of the deep sleep state. After uttering the word Om, the silence, Amatra, that follows is equated to Turiya, the background upon which the other three sounds are projected.